Hello, everybody, and welcome to The Hangar in Pitsburg, Ohio, Franklin-Monroe High School. Mark Bixler with you. Glad to be with you here tonight. And what a night of high school basketball. If this game is anything like the one we saw Saturday night between these two squads, it's going to be a barn burner right down to the wire. The championship game of the Bill Burkett Lady Patriots Tournament. Molly Clark hitting a runner of the right side wing as her Arcanum Trojans knock off the Franklin-Monroe Jets 53-51, a come-from-behind win for the Trojans over the Jets. Arcanum entering tonight, obviously 2-0 on the year. Franklin-Monroe at 1-1, but this is probably more important of a game than the Bill Burkett Lady Patriot Championship game. This is opening night of cross-county conference basketball, and what a game to start off the CCC season. These two teams figure to be at the top of the list. Franklin-Monroe, according to cccbasketball.com, the poll that the last time I looked at it anyway, Franklin-Monroe was picked to win the cross-county conference ahead of Arcanum. But the Trojans put a dent in that early on, as we said, with the 53-51 win over the Jets in the Bill Burkett Lady Patriot Tournament. Let's run down the starters here. First off, for the visitors from Arcanum, coached by Randy Odell, number 12, Brooke Strayer, a 5'4 junior. Emily Prince, number 14, a 5'9 senior. Molly Clark is a 5'4 senior wearing 21. Ashley Faulkner, a 6'1 sophomore, is wearing 32. And Brenda Denlinger, a 5'10 junior, is wearing number 41. For the Franklin-Monroe Jets, coached by Ned Gray, Mara Howe, number 12, a 5'4 freshman. Abby Davenport, a 5'8 junior, is wearing 13. Courtney Oswald, a 5'6 junior, is wearing 15. Elena Kakatolis, a 6'1 senior, is wearing 35. And number 42, a 6'1 senior for the Jets, Susan Post. And that, the starting lineups. We'll be back with the opening tip-off here tonight from the hangar in Franklin and Pittsburgh at Franklin-Monroe High School in just a moment. This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, RB Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
And we welcome you back here to the hangar at Franklin-Monroe High School. Mark Bixler, glad to be with you here for tonight's matchup. And we are underway as Abby Davenport takes the opening tip. As soon as Arcanum scores, well, some people sit down, but a lot of times Arcanum fans wait until the first basket. Not going to happen yet. Franklin-Monroe fans, the same thing. Kakatolis with the ball for the Jets. Defense! Oswalt out top. It goes to Davenport. Davenport guarded by Clark. Oswalt with it on the left side wing. That is Davenport out top. Fires the three. The long range three does not go. And the rebound to Denlinger. Mark Bixler with you. Glad to be with you here on Adelphia. Or check that. We were at Adelphia Cable last night as Clark fires the three, gets it to drop. But on the Eaton Time Warner cable system, glad to be with you for tonight's matchup. Cross-county conference matchup between the Jets and the Trojans. That does not go. Tipped out of bounds off of post, and it's going to be Arcanum basketball. 6:41 remaining, 3-0 Trojans. Clark. She'll get it into the front court for the Lady Trojans. Picks up her dribble, gets it off to Faulkner. Faulkner drives, fires, does not go, gets her own rebound. Dishes it off, and it's off of Arcanum. It'll be FM basketball as Mara Howe will trigger it in with 6:27 remaining here in this first quarter of play. It's a 3-0 Trojan lead. Ahead it goes to Post, Post to Davenport. Into the front court. Looks to drive. Dishes it off to Kakatolas. Back to Davenport. Howe looks to drive. Into Kakatolas. Off the glass. Good. So the Jets on the scoreboard with 6:05 remaining. And the Trojans with the one-point lead, though, at 3-2. That pass deflected away. Howe comes up with it. Strayer defending, and it does not go. Oswalt brings it back out to Davenport. Open for the three. Cannot get it to go. Kakatolas the rebound and put back. Good. And the Jets take a one-point lead at 4-3. Clark gives it to Faulkner. Faulkner looks to go low post to Denlinger. Denlinger. Back out to Faulkner, fires, too strong, the rebound to the Jets, as Davenport gets it into the front court. Davenport fires the three, cannot get it to go. Kakatolas rebounds. The baseline jumper, Mara Howe gets it to drop. And it's a 6-3 lead as the Jets on a 6-0 run right now. As that is deflected, it stays with the Trojans. 4:59 remaining. Mark Bixler, glad to be with you here on Time Warner Cable in Eaton. This cross-county conference matchup. We've got some great matchups coming your way on Time Warner Cable this winter. And hope that you enjoy the games that we bring to you. We started off with the Bill Brookett Lady Patriot Tournament. And what a tournament that was. The Trojans coming away with a last-second win in the championship game, 53-51. And the Jets looking for some revenge here. Clark underneath. Weak side got it to go. And it's a one-point lead for the Jets, 6-5. Davenport, as she gets it into the front court, being guarded by Clark. Oswalt drives, and I'm not sure who that was intended for, but it is a turnover, and it'll be Trojan basketball with 4:12 remaining. Clark in the middle, Denlinger does not get it to go as Kakatolas quickly out ahead. Nice tip pass, Howe to Oswalt, back off of Howe. And it'll be Trojan basketball, so maybe one too many passes right there by the Jets. Oswalt probably should have taken it on in. Strayer gives it up to Faulkner. Prince, the MVP of the Bill Burkett tournament. Faulkner goes up with it. Kakatolas whistled for the foul. Our officials tonight, John Adams and Mike Miller. Faulkner. First one does not go. She will get the second free throw as she was in the act of shooting. A chance to tie it up right here. And it rattles around and drops. So we're tied at six with 3:36 remaining here in this first quarter of play. Oswald picks up her dribble, and it's taken away. Strayer with the steal. She pulls up, fakes, gives it off to Faulkner, loose on the floor. Faulkner comes up with it, down to Strayer. Strayer out top to Faulkner. They try to get it into Denlinger. Denlinger kicks it back out to Clark, and she drug the pivot foot. A turnover, giving it back to the Jets as we are tied at six, 3:13 remaining. Oswald into the front court. She'll pull it out as hands it off to Davenport. Davenport, high post it goes, two post. Howe. Strayer guarding Howe. Post turns, fires, cannot get it to drop, and Clark grabs the rebound for the Trojans. Ahead it goes to Faulkner. Faulkner, nice move. Throws it off the glass, goes up with it, and Post is called for the foul. Got her on the arm. Free throw is good, and the Jets find themselves trailing the Trojans right now, 7-6 with 2:46 remaining. First quarter of play. And it rattles around and drops. And right now, Arcanum leading this by two, 8-6. Post, ahead it goes to Davenport. Davenport looks to drive, throws it up, doesn't go. Oswald the rebound. She puts it up, and it's off of FM. So with 2.5 minutes remaining, Arcanum with possession as Clark gets it into the front court for the Trojans. Brings it near side as that is Prince. Denlinger with it now. Out top it goes to Faulkner. Faulkner looks to drive. Dishes it off. And it is out of bounds as both Prince and Faulkner, or rather Prince and Denlinger, were on the line. So the turnover giving it back to FM with 2:17 remaining. We are still in the opening quarter of play. The inbounds pass goes to Post as Davenport has it now, and she'll get it into the front court. Kakatolis. Howe tries to go underneath the post, and it's a little too tall for her, and it's going to be a turnover as the Trojans get it back with 2:03 remaining. Clark into the front court, looks to drive, pulls up, the jumper does not go, loose. Kakatolis grabs the rebound as Davenport quickly gets it down to Howe. Howe off the glass, too strong, does not go. Deflected, Howe saves it back in, but Clark comes up with it. Clark, a two-on-one, and a whistle. She's going to be called for carrying the ball. A minute 40 remaining. Post takes the inbounds pass ahead to Davenport. Oswald looks to drive, but cut off. Davenport gets it back. Davenport drives, pushes it off to Howe. Howe, out top. She drives, fires it up. It's going to be a blocking foul against Strayer on the floor. Common foul with a minute 25 remaining in the opening quarter. Howe will trigger it in as Oswald takes the inbounds pass. Davenport with it out top. Fires off the glass, does not go. Howe grabs the rebound, feeds it into Post. Post the high off the glass, it's good. And we're tied at 8 apiece with just over a minute remaining. Clark She looks to drive at it. It's deflected, but she gets it back. Prince back to Clark. Clark to Prince. Cannot handle it, and the turnover as Post comes up with it. As Davenport quickly into the front court for the Jets. Underneath, nice defensive play by Brooke Strayer. Going up to get that and dishing it off to Denlinger, and Denlinger got it back. Clark open for three. Off the side of the rim, doesn't go. It's out of bounds off of FM. It'll be Arcanum basketball with just over 36 seconds remaining. Eight ain't the score. Arcanum taking the JV matchup, pulling away in the second half as that is saved back in by Post after she blocked Clark's shot. Prince will trigger it in on the near side. Clark takes the inbounds pass as we are now under 30 seconds remaining. Strayer. Denlinger on the far side. Back to Strayer. Tries to go inside. Kakatolas falls down, and that's automatically traveling. Out top it goes, Strayer. Clark looks to drive, the runner in the lane, high, as Denlinger right there. Johnny on the spot gets the rebound and the putback. And the Trojans back up by a deuce as that is out of bounds off of Arcanum. It'll be FM basketball with 4.2 seconds remaining. Well, Howell will trigger it in. The pass goes to Davenport. Took the shot at the buzzer. Did not go. We've completed one quarter of play here at the Hangar in Franklin-Monroe High School in Pittsburgh. It is Arcanum 10, FM 8.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, R.B. Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
Back here in Pittsburgh, Franklin-Monroe High School at the Hangar. Mark Bixler with you. Glad to be with you here on Time Warner Cable in Eaton. Second quarter just about ready to get underway. It'll be Arcanum possession to start things off here. 10-8, the Trojans leading this in this rematch. Second time these two teams have played in about 3 days. They played Saturday night at the Bill Burka Lady Patriot Tournament. Arcanum winning as Oswalt with the block. Kakatolas lays it in, rolls off, and Faulkner grabs the rebound. Faulkner dishes it off to Clark. Clark in the lane. Fires. Left it short. Denlinger, the rebound and putback, does not go. And the rebound out as Howe gets it into the front court quickly. Oswald fires. Does not go. And the rebound, it's going to be out of bounds, and it's going to be Arcanum basketball.
Oh,
Leander Brown checking in, as is Brandy Odell. Odell pushed it off. Inside it goes. Brown off the glass for two. And the Trojans leading this by four. 12-8. Powell. Underneath, intended for Kakatolis. It was deflected by Denlinger. And the steal as Prince gets it into the front court to Strayer. Strayer to Brown. Back to Strayer. Right side it goes to Odell. Odell back to Strayer. Prince. Denlinger has it now. Cross court, dangerous pass to Strayer. Top to Odell. Prince inside Brown. Kicks it back out. Back to Brown, and she'll get it back to Odell. She fires for three. Left it short, and it's out of bounds. It's going to be FM basketball with 6:07 remaining. 12-8. Arcanum with the four-point lead right now. Davenport, the runner. Left wing, got it to drop, left baseline actually. And it's a two-point ball game right now at 12-10 as Odell works, gets it into the front court. Prince gives it up, Strayer back to Prince. Brown looks to drive and a whistle, and Kakatolis is going to be called for a reach-in. Common foul as Clark and Faulkner check back in. Prince will trigger it in for Arcanum. Pass goes to Faulkner. Faulkner intended for Brown, and it's off of Brown, so it'll be a turnover. 5:26 remaining. 12-10. Gets it into the front court. Brings it near side, Oswalt. Oswalt looks to drive, cut off, and Kakatolis grabs the rebound. She'll put it up and gets it to drop. And right now, FM on a 4-0 run as we are tied at 12 apiece. And it's deflected out of bounds. It'll stay with the Trojans. 5:01 remaining. As we said, we're tied at 12. Mark Bixler, glad to be with you here on Time Warner Cable in Eaton. And Bixler Video Productions, and that is out of bounds off of Clark, and it's going to be FM basketball. And for those of you on, we'll have a doubleheader, National Trail doubleheader coming up Saturday as Davenport missed that. Put it back up, didn't get it to go, and here come the Trojans again. Faulkner skips across the rim. Odell the rebound and put back off the glass, and the Trojans back in front, 14-12. When they travel, the Blazers travel to Tri-Village. We'll have both. It's a boys-girls varsity doubleheader. Too strong, Kakatolis. Picks up a garbage rebound and 2 points, and we're tied at 14. Odell inside, Faulkner back to Odell. Top of the key, Prince to Clark. Clark to Odell. Faulkner, as she looks to drive, fires, does not go. Brown with the rebound. And I believe Brown is going to be guilty of a push. So with 3:48 remaining, we are tied at 14 here in the second quarter. Howell triggers it in as Kakatolis takes the pass. Ahead it goes to Davenport. Spittler, and it's off of Spittler. It should be Arcanum basketball. Well, that was off of Spittler. Clark fires, does not get it to go. Spittler grabs the rebound. Ahead it goes. Davenport to Oswald. Good. And the Jets in front, 16-14. Faulkner has it blocked. Jackie Ibe. 5'10 sophomore will be going to the charity stripe. Oswald guilty of the foul. Doesn't get that one to go. She will get the second, though. She was in the act of shooting. You can pull the Trojans to within one right here. And she does, as that one rattles around before falling through. 16-15, 3:07 remaining. Kakatolis, Spittler, nice move, but lost the handle, and she's going to be called for palming, double dribble. I think you have your choice there. Took a high bounce, one of those weird bounces in basketball. You'd think for having a round ball you wouldn't get those, but you get them occasionally. Well, they try to force it into Faulkner, just not there right now, as FM doing a nice job of double and triple teaming. Underneath, Howe dishes it back out. Davenport open for three. Good! 19-15, a four-point lead for the Jets. Faulkner fires the three, too strong. FM with the rebound as Davenport gets it into the front court. Tipped away. I believe that was Faulkner that reached in and got the basketball. Strayer checking back in for the Trojans. Inbounds pass goes into Davenport. Davenport looks to drive, cut off, picks up her dribble, Oswald. Pushes it back out to Davenport. Davenport, top of the key, off to Oswald. Oswald into Kakatolis, back out to Spittler. Spittler looks to drive down the lane, flips it up, and a whistle and a foul. It'll be a common foul, just the third whistled against Arcanum here in this first half of play, is Bethany Ibe in the ballgame. As that was foul, whistled against her, Spittler, and that is deflected out of bounds. It'll be FM basketball. Minute 46, 19-15 the score. Howell will trigger it in. The inbounds pass goes out to Spittler. Spittler to Davenport. Oswald with it now. Oswald underneath Kakatolis. Off the glass for two. And the lead is 6, 21-15. Jackie Ibe with it. Picks up a dribble. It's taken away by Howell. Pass intended for Strayer. Kakatolis. Davenport. Thought about the three, but Clark was right there. Spittler And Clark made sure that Davenport didn't make that basket. But Davenport's going to go to the free throw line to get two. 1:03 remains. Hard to believe that we've played almost two quarters of play. We played almost 15 minutes, and neither team has taken a timeout, as Casey Peters in the ballgame for the Jets. Gets the second free throw to drop, and it's a 7-point lead, 22-15. Clark. By the way, that was Clark's first foul. Strayer. Denlinger. Out top it goes. Faulkner. Okay, had to go up and get it. Clark fires for three. Got it. And how big is that? Makes a 7-point ball game. Four. Davenport ahead. It goes to Spidler. Spidler, the long range three off the glass. And just like that, it's a 7-point lead again, 25-18. Strayer. Faulkner looks to drive. Whistle and a blocking foul is going to go on Spidler. Just the fifth team foul, so it is still a common foul. So the Trojans will put it in play underneath their own basket. With 12.8 seconds remaining, just under 13 seconds. Prince off the glass, good. 25-20, a 5-point lead as Davenport takes the pass. Spittler. She kisses it off the glass for two, and that ends the first half of play. We've completed 16 minutes here at Franklin-Monroe High School with the score, Franklin-Monroe 27, Arcanum 20. Back with halftime in just a moment.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, RB Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
And we welcome you back to Franklin-Monroe High School, Pittsburg, Ohio, the Hangar. 27-20 the score here at the half. The Franklin-Monroe Jets leading the Arcanum Trojans in opening night action of the Cross County Conference girls basketball. A lot of similarities to the first time these two teams played Saturday night down at the Bill Burkett tournament, a close game early. FM opened it up, in fact, led by 10 points. Late in the third quarter, eventually it was an 8-point lead at the end of the third quarter. And then the Trojans lit it up in the final quarter to walk away with a come-from-behind, last-minute, last-second win over the
Jets of Franklin-Monroe and Cross County Conference, and for that matter, any conference, but it's important to win at home, especially if you're going to be one of the top teams in the conference. You got to protect your turf and then sneak away with some road wins that may be against some teams that maybe you shouldn't win against on their turf, but expect some close games in those situations, but maybe not win. And that's what Arcanum's hoping will happen, that they can come back, even though they're on the road, that they can come back and walk away with a win, a road win against one of the top contenders in the Cross County Conference. We'll be back with the start of this second half here at the Hangar in Franklin-Monroe at Pittsburgh in just a moment.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, R.B. Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
Back at Franklin-Monroe High School, the Hangar in Pittsburgh. Second half just about ready to get underway. As the officials ready for the action, Mike Miller handing the basketball to Mara Howe, and Abby Davenport takes the inbounds pass. Second half underway, a 27-20 lead for the Jets of Franklin-Monroe as Kakatolis dishes it back out to Davenport. Back into Kakatolis. 2 points, and it's a 9-point Jet lead, 29-20. Arcanum standing at 2-0 on the year. FM is at 1-1. Trojans would like nothing better than to see each team with a 2-1 record, and Kakatolis is going to be guilty of the foul as Denlinger went up with it. .726 remaining. Denlinger's first free throw is good, and it's a 29-21 ball game. Mark Bixler with you. Glad to be with you here on Time Warner Cable in Eaton. That rattles out, does not go, and Spittler grabs the rebound for the Jets. Davenport picks up her dribble, gets it off to Spittler. Spittler to Howe for three. Does not go, and Prince with the rebound, and Oswald is going to be called for going over top. Or at least attempting. And we'll have each of these teams one more time. And we will have Arcanum when they face Dixie. And we'll have another cross-county conference matchup as Faulkner struggling inside as Post comes up with that block. We'll have FM when they host Twin Valley South. Nice pass to Howe, couldn't finish, and the rebound goes to Strayer. Clark open for three, doesn't go. Denlinger the rebound, works her way through, and she's going to be called for traveling. Saw that one coming. Tried to get her balance as she worked her way through and just couldn't quite maintain it. Pass as Denlinger deflects it and Faulkner comes away with it. Faulkner to Clark. Clark tries to go inside as Prince is deflected. Faulkner puts it up, does not go. Loose, and I believe Faulkner, check that, I believe, well, let's wait and see. It's Clark that is called for the foul. It's what I thought he was going to call, but then I wasn't sure if he was going to call Clark or Strayer. Howe will trigger it in as Spittler takes the inbounds pass, and Howe will work it into the front court. Davenport looking inside, now goes baseline, puts it up, doesn't go. Post had it, and it's deflected away, and it's going to stay with FM. 5:57 remaining. Inbounds pass, post, has it blocked. Denlinger, and she takes it in, pulls up off the glass, good. 29-23. Prince. Mike Miller calling, saying that she didn't get the ball. She got the ball, but ended up getting a little bit of the wrist. Roosevelt's first free throw is good, so it's a 7-point lead again, 30-23. The second one on the way, it's good as well. One thing, Franklin-Monroe hitting their free throws a lot better here tonight than they were down at Tri-Village at the Bill Burkett tournament. Prince, Denlinger, Faulkner. An inadvertent whistle. It will be Arcanum basketball. Ned Gray wanting to know what took place.
Should have been a foul.
Inbounds pass as Strayer gives it to Odell. Prince. And she is called for traveling. Davenport. Roosevelt. And that pass is deflected. It's going to stay with FM. Howell for three, does not go as Clark grabs the rebound. Quickly the other way, a 2-on-3. She'll take it in, scoops it up, and she is fouled and will go to the charity stripe for two. Four
4:58 remains as Clark's free throw does not go. Hits off the iron and falls away, and Ned Gray wants to take a timeout, so we're going to take one here as well. But the score, FM 31, Arcanum 23. Welcome back to the Hangar, Pittsburgh, Ohio, Franklin-Monroe High School, a 31-23 lead for the Jets of Franklin-Monroe over the Arcanum Trojans. 4:58 remains. Molly Clark at the charity stripe to get a second free throw. Missed the first before the timeout. Chance to make this a seven-point ball game does not, as Mara Howell with the rebound. Davenport, Powell with it. Lob goes inside, deflected out of bounds off of Denlinger. It'll stay with FM. Powell triggering it in for the Jets. 4:43 remains as Oswald takes the inbounds pass. Spittler looks to drive down the lane. Cut off by Faulkner. It's blocked loose as Clark comes up with it. She'll push it up court. Loses it, gets it back, goes up with it, does not get it to drop. And Oswald comes away with it. Davenport and Denlinger called for the block. So Davenport will go to the free throw line to get two. .420 remaining, a 31-23 lead for Franklin-Monroe over Arcanum here on opening night of Cross County Conference girls basketball. The first free throw is good, 32-23. The second is also good. Boy, this game is shadowing that first game so far anyway. Inside, Denlinger doesn't get it to go, and Davenport grabs the rebound. Oswald, and a blocking foul is called on Odell. .357 remains. Little shot. Davenport, the three-pointer. Well, now we've taken a turn from the championship game, and Randy Odell electing to take a timeout. 3:45 remaining. It is Arcanum trailing FM 36-23. Back to the Hangar in Pittsburgh in just a moment.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, RB Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
Come on.
Back at Franklin-Monroe High School, a 36-23 lead as Molly Clark slipped but maintained her dribble, and Odell thought Brooke Strayer was going to zig, and she zagged. A turnover, giving it back to FM. Not what Randy Odell wanted to see coming out of a timeout. Davenport, as we are under 3.5 minutes remaining here in this third quarter of play. Dishes it off, and that intended for Post, and Strayer comes up with the errant pass. Clark goes inside. Denlinger kicks it back out to Clark. Clark looks to drive. Gets that to drop. A big basket, 36-25, as the Trojans pull to within 11. Oswald back out to Spindler as Howe dishes it off to Oswald. Davenport looks to drive, throws it up, does not go. The rebound doesn't go by Oswald, and Faulkner with the rebound. Faulkner. Strayer does not go. The rebound to Post, and Strayer nearly comes up with a steal. And they say it's off of Strayer. Close call, but I think the right one. .225 remaining. Howe. The lob goes to Post. Post dishes it off. Howe off the glass. Pretty shot. Franklin Monroe fans have a lot to look forward to with Mara Howe. Low post, nice feed as Prince takes down the lane, but she's going to be called for traveling. Inside Spindler, cut off. Davenport gets it back. Goes up with it. Couldn't control it, and the turnover gives it to Arcanum as Post. Rather, Clark lost the dribble. Inside Denlinger, Post. Davenport to Howe. 38-25. 1:05 remains. Post, high post. That is deflected, intended for J.C. Peters, as Denlinger deflected it. Faulkner pushes it off from just inside the top of the key. Doesn't go. It's saved back in, and Strayer tried to save it back in, but Denlinger was standing out of bounds. And Ned Gray electing to take a timeout, so we'll take one here as well. 51.6 seconds remaining, a 30-second timeout. Actually, we're going to keep it right here. Now, going back to a play earlier, and I've been around basketball, I hate to admit this, but going on probably around 35 years that I've watched basketball, and granted, I'm only 42, but I've watched players, especially at the high school level, really improve, and especially in girls basketball, I've seen a lot of improvement. And I can remember back in the mid-80s, a junior high basketball game that I was helping. My brother was coaching, and this young lady from Versailles' post goes up with it and gets it to drop.
somehow she managed to get it off, count the basket, and the foul goes against the Trojans. Kissed it high off the glass with 45.6 seconds remaining. As that is Prince's second foul, but the young lady from Versailles, the second free throw is good, 41-25, a 16-point lead. But Kenny Mann was officiating, and Versailles had a young lady that did a drop step at the eighth grade level, and Kenny called traveling, and she clearly did not travel. And I think sometimes officials just don't think that some athletes, high school athletes, can do some of the maneuvers that they do. Oswald tries to get it down low, and Denlinger tips it away. 3 seconds, they've got to get it off. Faulkner and Clark can't get it off in time, and that will end the third quarter of play as FM has expanded a 7-point lead, making it 16. The score at the end of three quarters, Franklin-Monroe 41, Arcanum 25.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, RB Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
Welcome back to the Hangar in Pitsburg at Franklin-Monroe High School. Arcanum with possession as we start this final 8 minutes. They find themselves down by 16 points. This is a team that knocked off the Jets at the Bill Burkett Lady Patriot tip-off tournament, 53-51. They're going to need another comeback here tonight, and it's not going to happen with plays like that. It's Davenport with a steal. Arcanum fans wanting traveling, but I tell you what, she didn't travel. She held that pivot foot. Faulkner gives it up. Clark inside, it goes to Prince from Denlinger. Out to Strayer. Strayer. She fires, cannot get it to go, and Faulkner with the rebound. She goes up with it. And Kakatolis with the block. It's going to be Arcanum basketball. Brown and Odell checking in. .7:17 remains. 41-25 as Clark triggers it out to Odell. Prince for three. Does not go. Faulkner the rebound. And a whistle, and traveling is called against Faulkner. Harassing,
Davenport, and Clark is going to be called for a foul. Now that, initially Clark did not foul, but it was after the ball was loose. Where that foul was called. And it's out of bounds. It's going to be Arcanum basketball. Still a 16-point lead. A lot of time remaining. Odell gives it to Prince. Clark with it on the far side. Prince has it again. Inside, they go to Brown, and a whistle and a reach in. And one thing in this type of a game, the officials are going to have to take control. Thus far, they've done a pretty decent job. And Elena Kakatolis needs to watch. You don't tell an official that you had the ball. Clark cannot get it to go. Loose. Odell grabbing for it. Loose. And it's out of bounds. And it's going to be Arcanum basketball. The official made the call, and you're not going to change his mind. Heads up play by Faulkner, letting it go into the backcourt. Clark puts it up, does not go. Loose. Prince battling for it. We've got a held ball. And on the alternating possession, it's going to be... It will be Arcanum basketball. Ned Gray is questioning. They had the tip, and I think we had a jump ball in between. Now, some fans are telling the one official that he doesn't have a clue, and I think it's going to be Franklin-Monroe basketball. Okay. But that's not the officials. That's taken care of at the bench, at the scorer's table. That's not the officials' responsibility to take care of. Clark is bumped down and no call, and finally a call, Davenport. Strayer and Denlinger checking back in. .605 remaining. Odell, still a 16-point game. We're exactly where we were at the start of the fourth quarter. Three-point goal, Ashley Faulkner, and it's a 13-point ball game. Could that be the start of a comeback? We'll have to wait and see. A lot of time, 5:40 remaining. Davenport with it out top. Oswalt, high post to Spindler. Spindler looks to drive. Guarded by Faulkner. Davenport underneath. Oswalt, nice job. Nobody was there defensively on the weak side, and an easy 2 points for Oswalt. Howell with a steal. Davenport, high post, Spittler. Oswalt, 4:56. And a reach-in is going to be called, and let's see. It's going to be on Clark. Davenport will be at the free throw line to get the 1-1, as that is the seventh team foul. 4:53 remaining, a 15-point lead, 43-28. Free throw is good as Jackie Ibe checks in, as she'll replace Brenda Denlinger. Ibe grabs the rebound. Off of the miss, 44-28, a 16-point lead as Odell with it out top. Faulkner drives in the lane, pulls up, good. 44-30, 4.5 minutes remaining. Spindler will hand it off to Oswald as she gets it into the front court. Underneath, Davenport, double-teamed, kicks it back out to Howe. Post, back to Howe as we're at the 4:14 mark. Davenport with it now. Post to Davenport, open for the three. Got it! 47-30. Odell gives it off to Faulkner. Ibe for three, short. Spindler with the rebound. Davenport works her way, is being guarded by Faulkner, and Faulkner's called for the foul. Davenport will go to the charity stripe to get the 1-1. At the eighth team foul, so still one more to give, and then the double bonus will be in effect. Doesn't go. Faulkner grabs the rebound for the Trojans. Still plenty of time. Almost 3.5, over 3.5 minutes remaining. Faulkner does not get it to go. And we've got a jump ball. This time it'll be Arcanum basketball. Three and a half minutes remaining, 47-30. Prince triggers it in as Odell takes the inbounds pass. Odell to Prince. Odell gets it back. She fires the three, doesn't get it. Strayer with the rebound, goes back up with it, and Post is going to be called for the foul. Strayer will go to the charity stripe to get two. .326 remains. 47-30. If you're a Trojan fan, you need every point. And Strayer can't get that one to go. She gets the second, as she was in the act of shooting. Kakatoulis checking back in. And she'll replace Post. Second free throw does not go loose as Howe comes away with it. Spindler gets the ball to Davenport, and she'll get it into the front court. Oswald. Howe to Spindler. Spindler cut off by Odell. Akatolis. Underneath, Kakatoulis backs up, takes the shot, does not go, and Prince with the rebound. Odell into the front court. And Oswald with a steal. And Odell is going to be guilty of the foul. still the 1-1. Brown checking in. Tracy Rodehamel in the game for the Trojans as well. Oswald's free throw does not go. Kakatolis goes up with it. And loose on the ground. It's still loose. And Denlinger finally comes up with it for the Trojans. 2.5 minutes remaining. Ive for three, does not go, gets her own rebound in the middle. It's tipped, and it's knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay with the Trojans. Still that 17-point lead, 47-30. Clark lobs it to Brown, up with it. Kakatolis with the block. Davenport with it out top. The 17-point lead as we approach the 2-minute mark. Kakatolis. Oswald to Spittler. A blocking foul is called against Rodehamel. Bethany Ive getting ready to check in. She'll come in at the after this free throw as Spittler gets that free throw to drop. And Bethany Ive replaces Denlinger. Got both free throws. The lead is now 19. Clark. Rodehamel goes to get it. Out top it goes to Clark. Left it short. That was tipped, and it's going to be out of bounds. It will be Arcanum basketball. 1:33 remains. Ive triggers it in. Clark looks to drive. Cut off. She fires, and it rattles through. 49-32. Davenport gives it up to Howe. Howe out top to Oswald. 1:11 remaining. Spittler to Davenport. Oswald in the paint, and it's a foul on Arcanum. We're going to take a quick break here. Brown with the foul. We'll be back with the free throws in a moment.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, RB Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville, Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
And we welcome you back here to the hangar in Pittsburgh as Oswalt's first free throw was good. 56.9 seconds remaining. It's an 18-point lead, so it's pretty obvious at this point that the Franklin-Monroe Jets are going to get a little revenge from Saturday night. Missed the second, though. That shot does not go. And it's going to be over and back. Wholesale substitutions as Clark remains in the ballgame, but right now for the Trojans. Megan Erlich, Tracy Rodehamel, Shayla Doherty, Bethany Ibe, and Jackie Ibe in the ballgame now for Arcanum. For the Jets, it's J.C. Peters, Allison Davis, Elena Kakatoulis, Abby Davenport, and Susan Post. And a whistle and a foul as Jackie Ibe is going to be called for that foul. 24.9 seconds remaining. FM will improve to 2-1 overall and 1-0 in the cross-county conference. Arcanum will slip to 2-1 and 0-1 in the CCC. J.C. Peters at the free throw line. The first does not go. The second is on the way, and it doesn't go either, and Erlich chases it down. Rodehamel into the front court. Ibe trying to go inside, intended for Doherty, and that is going to do it. 10 seconds remaining. Rodehamel with the steal. She lays it up, does not go, and it is Ibe battling for it. A whistle. Ibe was out of bounds with 1.8 seconds remaining. It will be FM basketball. 50-32, and that is going to be the final. Kakatoulis takes the inbounds pass, and that does it. The final score here tonight, Franklin-Monroe protects their home turf as they knock off the Arcanum Trojans. The final, Franklin-Monroe 50, Arcanum 32, back in just a moment.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville. The Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia. Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford. Cox Insurance Agency, RB Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville. Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta. By Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville. Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home. McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction. By Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview. Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison. By State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville. And by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
Welcome back to the hangar in Pittsburgh, Franklin-Monroe High School, where the Franklin-Monroe Jets just knocked off the Arcanum Trojans. 50-32, the final score, to improve to 2-1 overall and 1-0 in the cross-county conference. On the other hand, the Trojans fall to 2-1 overall and 0-1 in the CCC. It's a game where Arcanum jumped out to the first quarter lead of 10-8, but from then on, it was all Franklin-Monroe. The Jets outscoring the
Trojans 19-10 in that second quarter of play, and that set the tone for the remainder of the ball game. As again, Franklin-Monroe outscored Arcanum 14-5 in the third quarter, and then 9-7 in the final quarter of play, and that's where we end up here tonight, 50-32, the final score. We're going to take one more break, and we'll be back to wrap things up here from the hangar in Pittsburgh in just a moment.
This event brought to you by the Made Right Sandwich Shop at 125 North Broadway in Greenville, the Ansonia Lumber Company, 300 South Main Street in Ansonia, Greenville National Bank in Greenville, Ansonia, Gettysburg, Arcanum, and Bradford, Cox Insurance Agency, R.B. Cox Agency in Ansonia, Vinoy Cox Insurance Agency in Greenville, Homestretch Sportswear in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, by Montage Cafe on South Broadway in Greenville, Oliver Funeral Home, Greenville's only locally owned funeral home, McCabe Painting Incorporated, professional service with guaranteed satisfaction, by Osgood State Bank, with locations in Osgood, Fort Laramie, Chickasaw, and Lakeview, Family Health of Dark County, located in Greenville, Versailles, Arcanum, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your local agent, Jim Gable, East Main Street in Greenville, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. For more information on underwriting, contact us.
Welcome back to the hangar in Pittsburgh, Franklin-Monroe High School, wrapping things up here tonight, where the Jets get a little revenge after falling to the Trojans in the championship game of the Bill Burkett Lady Patriot tip-off tournament. The Jets protect their home turf here tonight, and that's what you've got to do in conference play. When you're one of the top teams, you've got to beat the other top teams if you play them at home, and that's what took place here tonight as Franklin-Monroe knocked off the Trojans of Arcanum 50-32. The Trojans fall to 2-1 overall, and they are now 0-1 in the cross-county conference, while the Jets improve to 2-1, and they are 1-0 and will be atop the CCC after week one, after the opening night of cross-county conference action. Again, the final score here tonight from Franklin-Monroe High School, FM 50, Arcanum 32. Glad to have you with us here tonight for M. Bixler Video Productions. Until next time, so long, everybody.